We all know that there are many great challenges facing humankind today. In agriculture, we need new food sources for our growing population and safer, target-specific pesticides without residues that harm the environment and kill beneficial pollinators like the bees. In human and animal health, we need safer, more effective and accessible medicines and the technology to respond quickly to future pandemics. At the Centre for Innovations in Peptide and Protein Science, or CIPPS for short, we aim to address these challenges. The Centre's funded over 7 years through the Australian Research Council's Centre of Excellence scheme and comprises world-leading scientists in the fields of chemistry and biology from 6 Australian universities. We have over 160 researchers and students working with leading industry partners and international research institutions at the cutting edge of modern science. Peptides and proteins are the main functional molecules of life, making up the fundamental machinery that drives the biology of all living things. Our mission is to discover novel peptides in Australia's flora and fauna, to decode how nature has evolved these molecules for specific purposes, and to develop them for translation into commercial products for agriculture, food, animal health, and the pharmaceutical industries.
Australia's separation from Gondwana 50 million years ago fueled the evolution of thousands of plant, animal, and microbial species that are found nowhere else on Earth. Our native flora and fauna have evolved a novel armory of peptides and proteins, such as those found in the venoms of unique Australian animals, like the platypus, and antimicrobial peptides found in the pouches of our iconic marsupials. Researchers across our centre are using advanced technologies to discover the secrets that are hidden within Australia's amazing biodiversity and identify peptides and proteins that may help solve the most pressing challenges of our modern world.
The Gurry or Fraser Island funnel web spider contains over 3,000 peptides in its venom, and we discovered one of these, called HI1A, could have amazing therapeutic implications. Stroke is one of the leading causes of death. We've found that in rat models, we can give the peptide up to 8 hours after a stroke and have shown that it actually prevents further brain damage from occurring. Our hope is that this molecule will one day lead to life-saving medicines for humans.
It's not always clear why some peptides can enter cells while others can't. We want to decode how these processes work so we can develop strategies and technologies that will allow any peptide or protein to reach its intended biological target. Combining cutting-edge chemical tools with our specific expertise will allow us to decode biological behaviour and visualise cellular systems in a way that's never been possible before.
Chemotherapy is one of the main treatments used to fight many types of cancer, and it is what we call a non-specific treatment, which means that they can kill better tumour cells, but they can also damage healthy organs. Our peptides, the ones we are trying to develop, they will target a specific cancer and they can heal the cancer from inside the cell.
So the challenge after discovering an exciting new molecule and decoding its function is to determine how to produce it at scale to ensure the commercial viability. Nature, of course, has evolved strategies to make these peptides and proteins efficiently, but we need to create our own methods in the lab to both generate the molecules on a much larger scale, but also to generate new versions with improved functions and properties. Along with our industry partners, we are striving to develop new synthetic technologies to build and customise peptides and proteins and deploy them for a range of applications.
I'm excited that as part of CIPPS, I'll have the opportunity to undertake an industry placement with AstraZeneca to take what I'm working on in the lab and see firsthand how it can be scaled up to create the essential products of tomorrow.
Over the coming 7 years, we'll embed a culture of responsible innovation and entrepreneurship, create the workforce of tomorrow, and drive new technologies that enable Australia to change the global face of agriculture and medicine.